Today we're going to take a look at what an operational amplifier is and some of the basic characteristics of an op amp. But before we get to that, let's just take a look at our regular amplifier, which I assume you must be familiar with. An amplifier is an electronic device used to increase the amplitude of a signal. So, suppose I have a signal VI at the input of my amplifier and the gain is A, then the output of the signal will be A into VI. One thing I want you to remember is that none of these are standalone signals. They are measured with respect to some common reference node, or ground as we call it. So the input VI to the amplifier is actually the difference between the input node and the ground node. Now then, what is an operational amplifier? It's basically just a high-gain differential amplifier, meaning that instead of taking the input voltage with respect to the ground potential, we measure it with respect to another signal. So, naturally an op amp has two input terminals instead of one. If I feed signals V1 and V2 into the inputs of the op amp, then I will get an output which amplifies the difference between V1 and V2, or put mathematically, V0 is equal to A times V1 minus V2 where A is the gain of the op amp. We'll denote V1 by V plus, and V2 as V minus. We draw an op amp using a triangular symbol with two input terminals, the positive and negative, and one output terminal. Note that the output here will be measured with respect to the ground potential. Let's do a little experiment with our op amp. Let's connect the positive terminal to a signal VI and let's ground the negative terminal. In this case, the difference between the positive and negative terminals will simply be VI. So at the output we'll get an amplified version of the input which is AVI. Now let's do the opposite. Let's connect the signal VI to the negative terminal and let's ground the positive terminal. Now in this case, the difference between positive and negative terminals is minus VI, so the output will be minus AVI. So, not only was the input amplified, but it was also inverted. For this very reason, the positive terminal is called the non-inverting terminal while the negative terminal is called the inverting terminal of the op amp. Now let's try to draw the transfer characteristics of this op amp. Like before, let's connect V1 at the non-inverting terminal and V2 at the inverting terminal. The output will be A into V1 minus V2. So, if I draw a graph of V1 minus V2, also called the differential input, against the output, I'm going to get a straight line extending infinitely on either side. The slope of this line will be the gain of the op amp. As you can see, the curve is quite steep due to the high gain value. Looking at this, you might get the impression that I'll be able to generate an infinite voltage at my output if I just keep increasing my differential input voltage. However, this is not what happens in reality. There's one crucial part of the op amp that I haven't shown you till now, and that's the supply voltages. Remember that an op amp is an active device. It needs an external power supply to amplify any input signal. A typical op amp has two supply voltages, one positive and one negative. The output voltage can't have a magnitude larger than the supply voltages. This means that if we keep increasing our differential input voltage, the output will increase linearly till a certain point after which it will just saturate at the value of the supply voltage. The region in which the output varies linearly with the input is called the linear region, and the region in which the magnitude of the op amp output voltage cannot increase further is called the saturation region. The maximum and minimum values of allowable voltages are called positive saturation and negative saturation voltages respectively. Now, before we dive into designing circuits with op amps, let's take a look at the circuit diagram of an op amp. Like any regular amplifier, an op amp has an input impedance Rin and an output impedance Rout. The output of the op amp will be the open loop gain, into the difference between the two input terminals. One question that may come to your mind is, what makes an op amp a good op amp? For that, let's take a look at what characteristics an ideal op amp has. Firstly, as I mentioned before, an op amp is a high gain differential amplifier. The higher the gain, the better. So, an ideal op amp should have an open loop gain of infinity. Next, if we attach voltage sources to the op amp, we would want the op amp to draw zero current from the source, so that all the source voltage will fall across the input terminals of the op amp. For this, the input impedance needs to be infinite. At the output, we want the entire output voltage to fall across any load we attach to it. This means the output impedance has to be zero. Other than these, there are a few more characteristics of ideal op amps, such as infinite bandwidth, infinite common mode rejection ratio, and an infinite slew rate. But we will take a look at these later. So, why are operational amplifiers called operational amplifiers in the first place? As you'll find out in the upcoming lectures, op amps are very useful in carrying out mathematical operations on signals. Right from addition and subtraction all the way to integration and differentiation, many diverse circuits can be built using op amps. One of the most commonly used op amps is the IC741, originally manufactured by Fairchild Semiconductors. It has an 8-pin dual inline package. This is the pin diagram of the IC. Pins 2 and 3 are the inverting and non-inverting inputs respectively, while pin 6 is the output voltage. Pins 4 and 7 are used for the negative and positive supply voltages respectively. Pins 1 and 5 are used for nulling any offset voltages, which is something we will see later on. Pin 8 is not used and should remain unconnected. As you may have guessed, real op amps such as the IC741 do not show ideal characteristics. To get an idea of this deviation from ideality, here is a comparison of an ideal op amp and a practical op amp specifications. The gain of a practical op amp is usually in the range of 10 to the power 5. The input resistance is around 2 mega ohms while the output resistance is around 75 ohms. Even though these are not ideal values, the gain and input resistance is sufficiently large for us to assume their values as infinity for all practical purposes. Similarly, the output resistance is low enough that we can neglect it while solving op-amp circuits. The IC741 has a slew rate of 0.5 volts per microsecond, common mode rejection ratio of 70 to 90 decibels, and a bandwidth of the order of 10 MHz. However, we will be exploring these quantities at a later stage in this course. That's all for this lecture. In the next lecture, we'll take a look at how we can control the gain of an op amp to make it useful for various applications. In particular, we will explore the virtual ground concept, which is the basis of most op amp applications. If you have any questions about this lecture, feel free to ask in the comments section. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe.